Hi Sildan, we were discussing in the previous video about 6C exercise. Now I will tell you about second question. Okay, first part. Divide, you will get three digit question. This is now three step question. Okay, how it is three step, you can see here. First of all, 4 and 7. Read the table of 4 up to 7. 4 ones are 4 and subtract it. This become 3 and bring this 5 down. Don't bring this 9 down. Okay, 9 in the next step you have to bring. Now 35 is divisible by 4, so we will not bring 9. Actually 3 is not divisible by 4, so we will bring 5 down. Then it become 35. Now it is divisible, then don't bring this 9. Okay, and now 4 table up to 35 is 4 8s are 32. It will be 32 here. Now 3 left here. Now you bring this 9 down, because 3 is not divisible by 4. You have to bring all the numbers downside, okay, till any other number left. Okay, 39, table of 4 up to 39, 4 9s are 36. Now subtract it, this will be 3. 3 is the remainder, answer is 189. Because 3 is not divisible by 4, 3 is smaller than 4, okay, and there is nothing left to bring down. So your question is over. So same way, if I show you here, 6 ones are 6, and here 8 minus 6 is 2. 2 is not divisible by 6. Bring this 2 down, it becomes 22. Read the table of 6 up to 22. 6 threes are 18. Now you can subtract 22 minus 18 is 4. 4 is not divisible by this 6. Bring this number down, 44. 4 7 6 7s are 42. Now 2 left here. Now there is nothing to bring from top to bottom, so this will be your remainder, and this is not divisible by 6. This way you can do all the parts, CD and CD in the book and other parts in the notebook. Now I will show you two parts of question number 3 also. Divide wash out the zeros of the quotient. Sometimes zero will come in the answer side. How it is coming, you see here, 4 table up to 2 you can't read, so take this 4 also, it becomes 24. Read the table of 4 up to 24. 4 6 za 24. Now you can see 4 minus 4 0, 2 minus 2 0, nothing is left. You have to bring this 6. Here it is 0, here also 0. This 1 here to bring down. But you are bringing 1 down, but 1 is not divisible by 4. Not divisible by 4, so this question is over up to here. This 1 is the remainder. But whenever you are bringing any one number to downside and it is not divisible by the divisor, then you have to put a 0 in the quotient for not divisible. Okay, 60. Correct? Now here also you can show the same problem. 2 table up to 10, 2 5s are 10. I am repeating again, 10 minus 10 is 0, but this 1 is left. For 1 you have to bring down, it is become remainder because 1 is not divisible by 2. But what you have to put here? 0. If you will not put 0, then it will be wrong. I will show you one more part. 6, 45 divided by 6, 6 1s are 6. Okay. Now bring this 6 minus 6 is 0. Bring this 4. See very carefully. This is also different. 4 here. Okay. Now 4 is downside, but 4 is not divisible by 6. So what you have to do? You have to bring this 5 also down. But whenever you are bringing two number together down, ek bar hi do number niche laenge, then you have to put a 0 here. Otherwise it will be wrong. Put a 0, then bring the next number down. Now 6 table. 6 7s are 42. Now what is left here? 3. So this way you have to do. I will show you one more part. 2 1s are 2. 1 left. Bring this 0 down. 5 2s are 10. Over. Nothing is left. But this 0 is left. This 0 you have to bring down. Any number when you bring from top to down, and this 0 is not divisible by 2. So you have to put a 0 here, 150 you have to write. If you write 15, it will be wrong. So this is the way how to put the zeros in the quotient side. I will show you four parts, other parts for you. Now mixed practice is given downside question number 4. That you have to do in the notebook. I will show you two, three parts. Just like first part is 882 divided by 4. When you divide 882 by 4, three step question. 4 table up to 8, 4 2s are 8, nothing is left here, bring this 8 down, 4 2s are 8 again, nothing is left, bring this 2 down, 3 step question, Now this 2 is smaller than 4, so it is not divisible by this. For not divisible, you have to put 0 on the top. Quotient is 220, remainder is equal to 3. And not 3, it is 2. Okay. Now the next is 806 divided by 3. 3 2s are 6, and bring this 2 is left here, bring this 0 down. 3 6s are 18, 2 is left here, bring this 6 down. 2 left, okay, 10, 1, 10 minus 8 is 2. 3, 8 is a 24, and now 2 is left here. Now this 2 is not divisible by 3, so it becomes remainder. So quotient is 268 and remainder is equal to 2. So this way you can do all the parts in the notebook. This is all about your exercise 6C. Now we will go directly to 6D, or if you want to see one more part, then you can go for this C part. 5, 1s are 5, up to 9 you have to read, 4 left here, bring this 1 down, 41, 5, 8s are 40, it will go by 8, 1 left here, and bring this 3 down, 5 table up to 13, 5, 2s are 10, 3 will be left, quotient is 182 and remainder is equal to 3. So this is the way to do division for 3 steps. You can pause it and you can write in the notebook and do all the parts. See, 3 part I did here. There are up to D, E, F, G, H, 5 more parts. You can complete it. So this way you can do exercise 6C. Now we will go for exercise 6D. Question is, solve these division sums. Be carefully how you use the remainder. Okay, you have to use the remainder also in some of the questions. Just like first question is 58 children were standing in a row of 9. Okay, how many rows of 9 children can they make? Now we will see here. Total children to arrange is equal to total children to arrange, like this notebook work it is, you have to write in notebook. Total children to arrange is equal to 52. Number of children in one row is equal to 9. Okay, then number of rows you can make is 58 divided by 9. You have to show the long division. It is 54. What is left here? That is 58 minus 54 is 4, 4 left, okay. So, so this quotient is 6. So, number of rows we can make 6. And how many students left for without row is 4. So, 4 children are left. And for them, we need to make a separate row, okay. So, total number of rows 6 plus 1, 6 plus 4, 1 is for this 4, okay. This 4 left 1. So, 7 rows we can arrange these children in 7 rows, okay. Now in this 6 will be equally divided as 9 students, and one row can have only 4 children. So same way, this second question is, Disa had 42 cells. She wanted to put them into the bag of 5 each. How many cells will not be in the bag? So you have to write total numbers, total cells. Disa have 42 cells in one bag, 5. Number of bags is equal to 42 by 5, and you do the division side by, you have to show this division here. 5 8s are 42 is left, okay. So 8 bags are needed and 2 cells are left. So this will be the answer. 8 number of bags needed, 8, and number of cells left is equal to 2. Now the next is, in a book exhibition, 28 books were kept on display with 6 books on one shelf. How many cells will be needed if all the books had to be displayed with nothing left out? Okay, no books would be left out. Total books to arrange is equal to 28. Books in one shelf is equal to 6. Number of cells needed, 28 divided by 6. When you do the division, 6 4s are 24. 4 will be the remainder. So 4 cells are needed. But for this 4 books, we need one more shelf. Okay. So more books needed to complete. No, more. How many more books you need? Actually, 6 are there in one shelf, but 4 are left. So 2 more books you must have. So more books needed to complete is 2, because if you put 2 more books, then it becomes 4 plus 2, 6. So one more shelf can be formed, that will be 5, okay. It becomes, then the number of books become 30, and 30 divided by 6 is 5. 5 cells are needed then. So here two more books are needed. Now next is total, this is your D part. In the party there are 50 people are there in the party, and people can sit in on around one table is 8. Okay, so how many tables are needed? 50 divided by 8, you know, 8 6 are 48, 2 is the remainder, so 6 table is left, but 2 people will be left. So for these 2 people we need to arrange one more table. So total tables needed 6 plus 1, 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. Same way the next question is total number of tires are given 35, okay, and the tires needed for one car is 4. So how many cars these tires can be fitted into, how many cars and how many will be left, how many tires will be left? So you have to make the statement like this: total number of tires 35, tires needed for one car is 4, number of cars can be adjusted with these tires 35 divided by 4. When you divide it by 4, 4 8 is a 32, 3 will be the left. So 8 cars it will be the answer, and 3 tires will be left because remainder is 3. So this way you can do this which part? E part. Now we'll go to the, you can pause the video to write all these parts. Okay. Now we will go to the next question. Next side of the paper, that is question number D. Question number D is D already we did, D and E. We'll go to the F part directly. F is bedspread needs 3 meter of the cloth. How many bedspread can be made by from 20 meter of the cloth? Okay, total length of the cloth is 20 meter. Cloth needed for one bed is spread is equal to 3 meter. Number of bedspread can be made 20 divided by 3, 6. Okay, and when you do the division, you know, remainder is left 2. So 2 meter cloth is left. So we'll write 2 meter cloth left. Okay. Now next is your this one. At an amusement park, 7 people can get into a boat ride at one time. Okay, how many boats will be needed for 52 people? Total number of people were 52. People in one boat 7. Number of boats needed 52 divided by 7. 7 7s are 49. Three people are still left. You see remainder is 3. So 7 boats are needed for all 7 7 people 7 time. 7 7s are 49. 3 remainder is there. For these 3 people we need one more boat. So total number of boats needed is 7 plus 1 8. Now the next is, a teacher had 27 pencils to distribute among 8 students. Okay, how he will distribute and how many pencils will be left? Total number of pencils 27. Number of students are 8. Number of pencils for each 27 divided by 8, 3s are 24. 3 pencil he will give to all, but still 3 are left. Okay, because remainder is 3. 8, 3s are 24. 3 will be the remainder. So pencils left is equal to 3. Pencils left with teacher is equal to 3. So mixed word problems are there in the next part. That is, they are saying solve using addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. You have to guess whether it is of addition, subtraction, multiplication or this one. So first one is 52 pencils are put into the boxes, 9 in one in each box. How many boxes are needed and how many pencils were left over? So we'll start here. Total number of pencils is equal to, total pencils is equal to 52. Then pencils in one box 9, number of boxes needed 52 divided by 9, and you saw the division this side. 9 5s are 45. Now 7 will be left. So you need actually 5 boxes, but one box for the left one. Left one are 7. So one box you need for these 7 pencils. So 6 boxes are total needed. B part is, Meenakshi's science book has 185 pages. Her English book has 215 pages. How many more pages does her English book have? So we'll write here, pages in English book is 215. Pages in science book is equal to 185. More pages in English book, then you have to do subtraction yourself. You can do, I think, this question. So this is for you. Now we will go for the next question. That is question number C part. 347 people So your C part is 347 people live on 32nd street now. There 3 years ago, 298 people used to live there. How many more people live on 32nd street now? Okay, so we will make the statement: people living in 32nd street now is 347 people living in 32nd street earlier, 215 more people living now. You have to do subtraction, that you can do yourself. You know the subtraction. Now the D part is 62 children in the class were put into the team of 8 each. How many teams did they make? How many children will be left out? So total number of children is equal to 62 children in one team, 8. Number of team can be made, that is 62 divided by 8. When you do the division, 7, 8 are 56. So your 7 teams can be made. What the number of children left are the remainder, that is 6. Now the next is apple in one basket is given 24. So apples in 7 basket, we have to find 24 into 7, 168. So there are some loose apples also. Number of loose apples is equal to 13. So how many total apples are there that is required? So 168 that are in the baskets and loose one are 13. So 168 plus 13 we can do. 8 plus 3 is 1, 11, and 6 plus 1, 7 plus 1, 8, and 1 you can bring down. So total number of apples are 180. This total number of apples are 181. Now the chapter checkup question number 1, 2, 3 you have to do yourself. They are the small question. Even 4 you can do in the notebook. 1, 2, 3 you can do in the book only. But 4th you have to do in notebook. And 5th I will discuss here. It is a word problem. 8 cakes were cut into 96 pieces. How many pieces were each cake cut into? Okay. Total pieces of the cake is equal to 8. Number of cakes is equal to 8. Number of pieces of each cake is 96 divided by 8. And you have to divide here to the right side. 8 ones are 8, 1, 6, 8 was just 16. So 12, a quotient is 12. So 12 pieces of one cake. And then 8 pieces, 8 cake has 12, 8 is 96. You can verify like this also. So this way you can do this chapter checkup question number 5A part in the notebook. Other parts, B part you have to do in the book. So you can see it, you can do it. Now we will see. Children, in this chapter you have to practice division. Actually, at least one week you can do 2-3 questions of division, then only you come to know how to divide in long division, two step division, three steps. So 2-3 questions you can daily if you revise. So 1, 2, 3 I have given in the book, 4th in the notebook, and 5th first part I have shown you. 6th part is, now they are saying that this table you have to fill. Okay, there are 15 apples and number of people who want it 7. Okay, so division statement you can write 15 divided by 7, and you just read directly the table of 7 up to 15. 7 2s are 14, so quotient will be 2 and remainder will be, quotient will be 2 and remainder will be 1. I wrote here also. So now they are saying number that each will get. How much each will get? 2. And number of the food item that is left, that is 1. 1 in the last. Same way you can do the second part. Here the 24 sandwiches are there. And in division you have to divide to 6. 4. Each will get 4 and no one is left. You can put 0 here. Okay. So this way you can do the last part yourself. So one more page is there, worksheet 1, that I will show you. Division in the circle, draw the lines and show it. Okay, so they are saying 12 divided by 4 is equal to how much is there, that you have to find using this dot on the circle. So you mark anywhere the dot and count 4 dot, 1, 2, 3, 4, mark here, then count again, 1, 2, 3, 4, mark here, 1, 2, 3, 4, fully divide, then join them. It give you a triangular shape, and the how many sides are there? 1, 2, 3. So the answer will be 3. Now I will show you one more part, then other parts for you. 18 divided by 3. Any point, from any point you can stay. Count 3 dot. 1, 2, 3. Join a line. 1, 2, 3. Join one next line. 1, 2, 3. Next line. one, two, three, next line, one, two, three, next line, one, two, three, yes, it is also completed, one, two, three, four, five, six, six, and it is a hexagon shape, okay, so this way you can do 18 divided by 5, 5, 5 point here to join, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but here now you can see 5 points are not there, but it is left, how many left, 1, 2, 3, 3 dots are left, so quotient is 5 and remainder is 3, if it is not completed all the lines with equal point, then how many points are left, that become the remainders. So this is this page you can do 126. This is all about your chapter. I suggest you again to do 4-5-5 questions or 2-3-3 questions daily for 1 week. Okay, then only division will be clear to you. Okay, children, thank you.